Good morning. This face is saying like exhausted, tired. Homework, oh my gosh. It's only Wednesday and the week already has been exhausting. I don't know if I want to keep doing all these activities with my kid. Like, some of them are social, but some of them are for school, for church. And it's only Wednesday and we've done like 4 things already. Like, backtracking back and forth from the city, from the server. It's just been a lot. And tonight, it's the same thing. Pick him up, drive back to the city. His something else he has to attend to. But honey, tomorrow's Thursday. Today starts the spring break because today's his last day until next week on Tuesday. So, do you know that means, like, good God, honey, no activities. Like, I know he's going to have another game, but he's not going to be here. So, like, thank you, Jesus. Like, drum lessons on Sunday, and it's just always something. And maybe I won't tell him, but, like, we won't do soccer, you know. Listen at my breaks. I just paid this money to get them corrected and they're still making noise. Anyway, an update. There's always something with family, you know, always. But glory be to God, honey. He talked to his father last night. Things kind of went sour. And Jared was basically just finally kind of speaking up for himself, to be truthful. That's all it was. He was just speaking up for himself. I should have went that way. He was just speaking up for himself, and when he got off the phone, he came into the living room. We were talking, and you know, same old, praying for him, talking, encouraging him, yeah, yeah, yeah. Reminding him that he still has to pray for his dad, honor and respect his dad, in spite of. And then he called my sister. Ever since he was little, like, she's been like a healing balm to him. You know, it's her spirit, her voice, like everything. Yeah, my sister is a little, the amazing side she is. And I'll say within like the first 2 minutes, you know, his voice start like cracking. You can tell like he wanted to cry. And I just felt so bad for him because his dad doesn't see his point of view. And now that Jared's really, really just trying to speak up for himself, he has so many emotions, like kind of bottled up inside. He doesn't know how to adequately express himself. But it's a start. I mean, he did from, I think, last week. And they were talking through text or whatever, but I pray, like I've been doing, that God would restore, well, I was about to say restore the relationship. They really never had one. I'm talking about like a true father-son. Jared knows that's his dad and things like that, but they don't spend and haven't spent, you know, really quality time together. And I'm just hoping and praying that things would change. That's all. That's his father. So, oh, yes, God. Let's go back. Let's go around the bus. Come on. Yeah, honey. I cannot sit behind that bus. I'm sorry. You know, stop and go. Anyway, yeah, so that's that. I was getting dressed this morning. I laid in the bed a little too long. My body was just like, thank you, Jesus. And Jared was in there moaning like, Mom, please. Can I stay home? I'm like 4. I'm tired. Well, you're tired because you're in tons of activities. You know, all these things you want to do. So, if I can rip a run, spend money, burn gas, backtrack, and getting home at like 9:30, 10 o'clock every night, honey, get up and go to school. you know, you have to tell Jared, like, okay, you're tired, babe, you're right, you're tired. So let's not do A, B, C, D, E, F, O, and G. You know, so you will be tired. And then he's like, oh, never mind, give me them letters back, you know? Like, we'll get it together. Anywho, what was I gonna say? Oh, I heard him on the phone this morning, and he's only on the phone early in the morning. We know weird times if it's his dad or his brother Jalen, you know, whenever both of them call or they talk. But what did he make up for? And he was like, Mom, my dad wanna talk to you. So I'm like, oh God, is this gonna be a happy phone call? So, you know, it's like, good morning. As I'm trying to think in my mind as far as homework today, work stuff, what am I wearing, why I'm in there cooking eggs, and, you know, single mom hustle stuff. And he asked if Jared can come up this weekend. Absolutely, I want you to see your kid, honey. My son needs to see his father, you know. So I guess it just came together this morning that, oh, he can come. And I'm like, well, we're not prepared. I haven't packed. Now, granted, I could have probably, like, finagled and, like, left work early so I could come home and pack and things like that. But, he has an appointment anyway for this private school program at 4:30, and I already rearranged the time twice already. And when you're trying to obtain something, you know, constantly rescheduling, it doesn't look good. So unless it's an emergency, I wasn't going to do it. So we're meeting tomorrow, and and I just have to take him to work with me. I have a meeting tomorrow too, and I have to, let's see how this is going to go. So maybe we can meet at 2, yeah. And then we can just leave, yeah. Or 1, I can just leave early tomorrow. But yeah, I just hope things really just go well. It's difficult every time there is, you know, it doesn't have to be difficult, because I'm thinking to myself, if I was a step parent, as long as the mother or the father was normal, you know, they didn't have any hang-ups, any emotional issues, any, you know, all the extra stuff that comes with not knowing yourself and not really properly healing. Because as a stepmom or stepdad, I really don't believe I'll give any problems. The same way I am with Jared, you know, music mom, soccer mom, basketball mom, baseball mom, school mom, PTA, you know, church activities, you know, summer camp. Everything I do with him, I would do with them. You know, it's only right. What time is it? I'm on time, honey. Good God. Yeah, I would do the same thing. So, I don't know. Everybody's different. Everybody's like in a different headspace, you know, so. But alrighty. So he goes and he comes back Monday. So, because he goes back to school Tuesday, I think. Yeah, I think it goes back Tuesday, so he'll probably come back Monday. So, I hope that his experience is nice. He's staying with his grandma. He feels more comfortable in how things have been since his dad's been married with his new family. until the kinks can be worked out and the adults, not the children, the adults can, you know, buckle down and really try to get to the bottom of what's going on. If the child shared what's wrong, you know, what's wrong with him, how he feels, then it's up to the adults to really try to see her through, you know, what's really going on. A lot of times people will forget that Jared indeed is just that, a child, because he's smart for his age. How he can talk, and it's because I trained him that way too. Like, it's just us. So, you know, just because you're 11, it's not like we're not like, goo goo, okay, honey. I've been teaching him like scenarios and how he should talk and things like this since he was like 4 or 5. Now, if someone says this, you can say this and do this. And so when it doesn't help either that, you know, he'll be 12 in May, but he's what, like 5'5", 5'6" or whatever. No, he's 5'5½" or he's 5'6". So with him being tall and big and being able to carry on a conversation and comprehend very well, people forget that he's still a child. So, because I even do it, so you can't tell me no one else, you know, doesn't relatively forget. Ooh, Jesus, look. Out the shower and just dress. Look at, honey, look at my hands. Ooh, Jesus. Ashman, Ash. But alrighty, so I guess that's like a semi-praise report. You know, Jared spoke up for himself, slash he's going to see his other family, his dad and his grandma and his granddad for the weekend. So, you know, a little time is better than no time. It's not consistent, but, you know, Jared still gets to see his grandparents and his father, even if it's for a little while. Alrighty, God bless you people. Thanks for watching. Bye.